Hi, my name's Scott Hebbard from Sparx Systems, and today I'll discuss the National Information Exchange Model and Enterprise Architect. NIEM is a robust standards-based framework for the exchange of information between people, organisations and communities. This webinar will demonstrate how to produce a NIEM subset using the Schema Composer. At the completion of this webinar, you should have a greater appreciation of how to implement NIEM using Enterprise Architect. Let's start with a real-world example where two or more states need to exchange information in order to conduct a prisoner transfer. Unfortunately, each state uses different terminology to describe common elements and may even use different database structures to define information. A protocol must be established for the two states to communicate reliably. However, these differences make information exchange complex, costly, and difficult to negotiate. For example, one state may use the term prisoner, while another state may use the term inmate, even though they are talking about the same underlying object. NIEM helps to alleviate these problems by providing a standard framework approach to describing information exchange that all parties agree upon. Neither party has to change their database, yet they can reliably share information. This webinar will examine the benefits of using Enterprise Architect to model and define how information can be shared based on NIEM principles. This approach helps to overcome the challenges of different databases by using a community-driven, standards-based approach to modeling and exchanging information. How does Enterprise Architect facilitate information exchange? Let's take a look at a completed example of Enterprise Architect and NIEM. The goal of this exercise is to facilitate the exchange of information about a person using NIEM and Enterprise Architect. This could be for a prisoner transfer, interstate adoption, hospital ward transfer, warrant request, terror suspect watch list, or countless other examples. So let's look at our Enterprise Architect solution, generate a subset and produce some artifacts including an MPD diagram and IEPD. The project browser contains three packages including a NIEM reference model, NIEM MPD types and a NIEM starter model. All three packages can be created via the model wizard as shown on screen. NIEM was born out of a desire to create a reliable and consistent information exchange between emergency services, justice departments and law enforcement agencies after 9/11. Some of the history of this is evident from some of the domains listed including biometrics and emergency management. The reference model contains NIEM core and several different domains. For this particular webinar, we're going to focus on NIEM core. NIEM core describes components that are universally understood by all parties, covering everything from an address type to a person type. These definitions facilitate information exchange. The NIEM starter model contains our NIEM core subset that in turn represents the information that would be exchanged to identify a person. You can see that we've defined person type using a birth date and person name, which is further made up of a given, middle, and surname. We also have a model package description that outlines and visualizes the contents that will be generated in our IEPD, with links to elements such as a changelog, conformance targets, and much more. All of this is modeled in Enterprise Architect, and from this diagram, a simple context menu can be used to automatically generate a corresponding IEPD. The IEPD, or Information Exchange Package Documentation, is a collection of artifacts that define and describe the structure and content of an information exchange. On screen, we have all the packages that make up our IEPD. We also have our XML schema that describes the information that is being exchanged. This code is the basis for cost-effective and reliable information exchange between two or more parties. Now let's step through the process of creating a NIEM core subset and automatically generating an IEPD using Enterprise Architect. What are the required steps to generate an IEPD? First, you need to open the Schema Composer and create a transform. Select the desired classes and attributes applicable to the information exchange, create a NIEM subset and save to your model, and then generate the corresponding IEPD. To build our NIEM subset, we need to use the Schema Composer in Enterprise Architect. Select Tools followed by the Schema Composer. Create a new model transform, providing a suitable name and ensuring that you select NIEM from your chosen schema set. The namespace can be left blank because it is derived from NIEM. The transform output will be saved as a model artifact rather than an external file. We shall save it in the starter model under the package called MyMPD. MPD is short for Model Package Description. The Schema Composer has three columns to display classes, attributes, and the schema itself. I plan on selecting classes that are found in NIEM Core, and will use the search capability within the project browser to find Person Type. Drag the Person Type class into the column on the far left of screen. This class stores all information that is commonly associated with identifying a person. There are a large number of attributes that can be used to describe a person, however, I want to create a subset that includes date of birth and name. Use the checkboxes in the attributes list to select attributes for person birth date. If I select the attribute person birth date, the Schema Composer automatically adds the type date type to the list of classes, as these are referenced by the attributes you have just selected. The NIEM model commonly uses XML schema abstract elements and substitution groups. The abstract elements add some complexity to the creation of a subset because you are required to add an abstract element as well as those elements that will be substituted in place of the abstract element. Now that we've successfully added the date to our schema, we need to add the name. Select the Person Type class in the left column, scroll down and select Person Name. I can then further define Person Name Type to include a given name, a middle name and a surname. The schema is displayed in the right hand column. Press the Update button and generate the results as an internal model artifact. We've now described an information exchange about a person using their birth date and name. Now that we've created our NIEM Core subset, I can drag the NIEM UML classes onto a diagram. The diagram helps us to visualize and understand the various inheritance relationships. For example, person type consists of person birth date and person name, which is then further defined as having a first, middle, and surname. We can also identify how the date is represented. Now let's generate our IEPD from our MPD diagram. From our MPD diagram, we can use the context menu. Simply select extensions, followed by NIEM 3, and generate the NIEM 3 schema. You can see the results appear in the system output window. The MPD diagram acts a little like a table of contents where you can itemize all of the components that will be included in your IEPD. Let's have a look at the IEPD now. You can see there is a folder structure with NIEM and extension, and within the NIEM core package, we have our XSD file. On screen, we have the XSD file that Enterprise Architect has produced. You can see the person name type, which is a type definition, a complex type made up of three elements. Those three elements appear in the sequence below. So you have a person given name, person middle name, and person surname. Scrolling down the page, each of these three items are further defined with a type definition for person name text type. The NC represents NIEM Core. You can see that the person name text type is used for both the person name, person middle name, and person surname. Person name text type is a data type for a name by which a person is known, referred, or addressed. Is an extension of proper name text type and consequently a text type and a simple string. So all the inheritance relationships are embedded in the code so there is no ambiguity about the information being exchanged. A similar process can be followed for birthday. Let us now take a look at a slightly more elaborate example. This first diagram is an example NIEM core subset. In addition to the person type and date type, this example includes an image type as part of the subset. The second diagram is a subset of our biometrics domain, where we define a face image type of type image type. Coordinates are used to identify features in the face image. We also have a diagram that represents our personalized message request for a face image type. So this diagram represents the payload or content of the document that will be exchanged. The next diagram is a personalized message response, which will consist of a greeting and a person's name, which you may recognize from NIEM core. The next diagram is the personalized message PIM. The items in blue come from NIEM core, while the green elements come from the biometrics domain. At the top, you have your personalized message request with an image and a corresponding response. The next diagram is our MPD diagram. You can see it specifies the personalized message request and the corresponding personalized message response. In this webinar, we outlined how to generate NIEM conformance schemas from your information models. We outlined how the NIEM standard facilitates information exchange using two examples. And we also outlined how the Schema Composer is used to create a subset of the NIEM core reference schema. For more information about Enterprise Architect, please visit www.sparxsystems.com.